time for the NHL 2000 moment. Mario Lemieux defined the Pittsburgh Penguins of the 90s, leading the team to back-to-back Stanley Cups. Game 4 of the 97 quarterfinals against Philadelphia was Mario's last home game as a player. With a 3-1 lead over the Flyers and less than 2 minutes to go, the crowd wanted one more Mario miracle.
1:10 to go. Here comes Mario. Mario! Magnificent!
Mario has punctuated this victory for the Pittsburgh Penguins by scoring one more time on a breakaway in front of his family and his hometown crowd.
Well, it was just a great opportunity for me to score one more goal for the fans, so I took advantage of it, went down, made my favorite move, which was open up the legs of the goalie and go five-hole.
Is it not fitting that this game should end just like this?
The fans showed their appreciation for the hometown's greatest.
The fans have been there for me through a lot of tough times here in Pittsburgh, and you know, I was just expressing my feelings towards the crowd tonight, and you know, it was just a great moment.
You got your wish, Paul. And so did all these fans. Incredible, what a feeling.
That was the first time I cried on the ice. It's the first time in my career I did that, so it was very emotional at the end, and that's something that I'll remember for a long time.
Mario Lemieux shocked the hockey world on December 11th when he announced he was going to return to the game after a 3.5-year retirement. Lemieux will be the first owner to play for his team.
I do miss the game tremendously. I think most of you know that I play this game to win championships. And I truly feel that this team is very, very close to competing for the Stanley Cup, and that's why I'm back, to help these guys achieve our goal.
The Hall of Famer's motivation for returning was a bit personal as well. He had his family in mind, especially his youngest son, Austin.
He's certainly been a big part of my life since the day he was born. He's a young kid that gets up early in the morning with his hockey stick in his hands and loves the game of hockey. And I'm sure he would love to see his dad play before it's too late.
His comeback allows everyone to once again watch in amazement as Super Mario and Jaromir Jagr are reunited.
Jagr, what a move. Look at him go.
I think that he's going to be a strong force for the Pittsburgh Penguins. And the one thing that he really has in his favor is he's coming back. He's going to get to play with probably the best player in the game next to him. So that makes life a lot easier.
Lemieux laced up his skates for the first time on December 19th to join Jagr and his Penguin teammates for practice in front of 500 excited fans.
I was a little bit surprised when I stepped on the ice. There was a lot of people here and of course the press. And that's always nice to see that we get the fan support and people are anxious to see me back on the ice. And it's a good feeling. Overall, I felt pretty good. My legs were pretty strong skating-wise. And I think it's just going to be a matter of getting used to the traffic again. I think everybody's going to have to be a little bit patient. Obviously, after 3 years of not competing, I'm not going to step on the ice and score 5 or 6 points my first game.
And how does Mario want to score his first goal when he returns against the Toronto Maple Leafs on December 27th?
Breakaway, top shot.
Mario Lemieux's first game is right here in Streaks and Deeks East.
Okay, how many goals do we want, Daddy? Four.
Three.
100.
100.
Well, that's going to take a couple years at least.
How about just one to start?
Yeah, we'll try one tonight.
No, 100.
Oh, okay.
10.
Super Mario knew everyone was counting on him. Not only his family, but hockey fans from all over the globe. Number 66 came down from the rafters, and now Mario was officially back.
Looks like a Stanley Cup Game 8. That's what we're calling it. Buffalo, a loser move. These pants are Dina. And went in. Hang on. Will we have a video review on the first possible point for Mario Lemieux, who was out there with Herdina and Jaromir Jagr? 33 seconds into the game, Mario Lemieux will get an assist. Jaromir Jagr will get a goal in his first shift back. 33 seconds, and Lemieux has had an impact in the game. Let this fairy tale begin. Mario, of course, is only 35, and he's out there. Jagr, Herdina, Jagr with it. Lemieux in the middle, Lemieux!
said at the end of the first period, now if I can only get my hands back.
They're back. They could write this novel, but no one would buy it because it's not believable.
The night was already a success, but Mario was having too much fun to stop now.
Who's what? They believe now in front of Hernandez. It's back and he scores. Hernandez makes it 4-0. And Lemieux gets his third point on a brilliant pass from the corner. Mario's going to continue that 2 points per game average. And mama's cheering.
With the Penguins shorthanded, Mario took a break and watched his captain take over.
Oh, yeah.
What a comeback.
And tonight's number one star, another goal, Mario Lemieux.
It was exciting to step on the ice once again and be a part of this team, and I'm looking forward to the rest of the year.
3 nights later, Ottawa was Lemieux's second opponent. Mario assisted on Robert Lang's first period goal, but the Senators went ahead 3-2 in the second. Number 66 and company had work to do.
Need to get it back. They need to work to behind the net. Lemieux will bring it out. Got a screen shot. Save. Rebound. Score! There's Lemieux again. Setting up Jagr. And it's 3-3. 1,000 points for Jaromír Jagr. Deflected in front. Lemieux centered. Corbet. Lemieux. Lemieux centered. Score!
Just amazing.
The Jagr extends the ball to the news on the other side. Empty net. Empty net. Empty net. Score! Mario Lemieux!
2 goals and 5 assists in his first 2 games back after being out for over 3.5 seasons. The fun just never stops in Pittsburgh in the last few days, and it won't for quite some time.
And here's this week's classic moment. Ever since Mario Lemieux was drafted number one in 1984, the struggling Penguins franchise was hoping he would be the one to lead them to the promised land. And in the 91 playoffs, everything came together for Lemieux, who guided Pittsburgh over Boston for their first Wales Conference Championship. The only team standing in the way of Lord Stanley were the surprising Minnesota North Stars. In game two, Mario gave the hockey world a performance they'll never forget.
Here's Lemieux starting out. Penalty back to the play as Recchi was knocked out. Lemieux dances and it scores!
You really don't need a game plan when you've got a guy like Mario Lemieux.
And Mario dazzled once more in game six, leading the Pens to an 8-0 shutout and the 1991 Stanley Cup.
The Conn Smythe Trophy winner is that man, number 66, Mario Lemieux.
It took Lemieux 8 seasons, but finally he had Pittsburgh on top of the hockey world.
The incredible Mario Lemieux has given us as many memories as almost any player in the game.
Mario! Magnificent!
But one of the most incredible accomplishments has been largely forgotten. It was New Year's Eve 1988, Pittsburgh hosting New Jersey, and Mario made history.
Broughton trying to cut the angle off Lemieux, and Broughton, Lemieux in, score! His 7th shorthanded goal of the year. They've got the full 2 minutes. Score! Mario Lemieux, the perfect trick!
Goals in even strength, shorthanded, and on the power play gave Mario a unique hat trick. And when the Penguins were awarded a penalty shot, Mario had a chance to cash in again.
That's it! 4 goals for Mario Lemieux, a penalty shot!
4 goals, 4 different ways, every way possible, except one.
Front the new dudes, he scores! Mario Lemieux has his 5th of the game! What a story for Mario Lemieux, is he fantastic?